Hi everybody! I get asked all the time how I get this rotating model 360 in the bottom left corner down there, and today I thought I would show you just how to do that in Blender. A speedrun version of this tutorial for experienced Blender users. You're just going to add an empty to the center of your scene and animate it so it's rotating 360 degrees on the Z axis. Next, you're going to add a camera to your scene and you're going to parent it to that empty. Next, to actually watch your animation, you're just going to open up two extra 3D viewport windows here on the left and press numpad 0 to toggle into the camera view here. And I like to press Z to toggle overlays off while that animation is playing, and then move your camera and empty into their own separate collection here on the right, turn it off, and now you don't have to watch them all the time. And now, the tutorial in much greater detail. Alright, so to get started, you just need to go to your output properties over here on the right, and you're going to change your aspect ratio from 1920 by 1080 to 1920 by 1920, so your camera is nice and square. And then I would change the frame range from the default 250 to 180 frames. That isn't particularly important necessarily, but for me personally, I like the rate of speed of a 360 that is 180 frames long, moving at 24 frames per second. So now that we've gotten that taken care of, you're just gonna press Shift A to add an empty to your scene. You're gonna choose plane axes right here. I have to toggle into top view to add things. I don't know why, but if you know why that happens, let me know what I need to do. It's weird. Anyway, you're gonna add your axes to the scene, and now you're just gonna go to this transform menu right here. If you don't see that, you can just press in to open that menu right there on the side of your screen, and you're gonna go to the rotation values. And what we wanna do is hover over the Z rotation and press I, and that's just gonna add a keyframe right on frame 1 in the timeline at the bottom of your screen. So now we're gonna grab the blue thing and scrub all the way to your last frame. For me, that is 180, and go right back up to the Z rotation value on the top right of the screen and change that value to 360 degrees. Once again, press I while hovering over it to add a keyframe on frame 180. And now if you just press the space bar, you should see that your empty is now rotating. It is rotating. You'll see it slows down at the end, it speeds up at the beginning. Personally, for me, I like for a 360 animation to be moving at a constant rate of speed. So I'm just gonna pause that animation, select the empty again, press A down here on the timeline to make sure I grab both keyframes, and then press T to open the keyframe interpolation menu and select linear interpolation. Now if I press the space bar, we have a constant rate of motion. Look at that. Okay, wonderful. So that's most of the hard work that we have to do to set this up. Now we just need to add a camera. So I'm just gonna zoom out a little bit and then press Shift A. Once again, go right down to camera. And then I'm going to press numpad 0 to toggle into the camera's view, and I'm going to go to the view menu up here on the top right, and I'm going to select lock camera to view. And now if I just scroll down, my camera will move away from the center of the scene there. And I'm going to check that again so the camera doesn't keep moving with me when I want to adjust my view in the viewport. And now if I just get out of that view by shift middle click, you can see our empty is still rotating, but we need our camera to now orbit around our model by following the empty. How do we do that? We need to parent the camera to the empty. All you have to do is select your camera and then shift click the empty, press Control P, set parent to object. And now when you press the space bar, you have an orbiting camera. How exciting. Okay, I'm gonna let that animation just run. And now what we need to do is right down here in the bottom left, I'm going to click and drag my viewport window to the right. This opens a new viewport window over here. And I'm going to click and drag the bottom left corner of this new viewport again. I'm gonna drag it up this time, and this is where I like to have my animation playing. So now with my mouse in this viewport down here, I'm just going to press numpad 0 to toggle into the camera's view, and I want to get some of this UI, is that the right word? These menus out of the way. I'm gonna press T and then N to get these menus out of here. Oh, Am I locked to camera view? Nope, I'm all good. So press T and N to get rid of these two menus, and now I'm gonna press Z to toggle my overlays off, and then I'm gonna press Z again to toggle into rendered view from solid view, and I'll just kind of scroll up to zoom in a little bit, and I like to just adjust this view so I don't see the edges of my frame or anything. It's just the 360. And that's pretty much it. The other things you should do, make sure you scroll, you click and drag the timeline down so it's out of sight, or people will complain about it and all of your time lapses, speaking from experience. Another great thing, I like to make sure that I don't have this actual empty in camera constantly in view while I'm working. So what I'll do is I'll go up to my scene collection here in the top right. I'll just right click new collection. I'll name it something like tools by double clicking. And then I'm gonna pause my animation real quick. And then I just grab the empty and the camera, drag it into that new collection that I made named tools, uncheck it, and now it's hidden. But my animation is still playing. I have a wonderful 360 that I can reference while I work. It's super helpful, very easy.